What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of TVP Versus, where we're putting the best of the best and the worst of the worst in Las Vegas head-to-head to see who ultimately reigns supreme. In today's episode, we've got a battle of two popular budget hotels. We've got the Two Queen Pyramid Premium Room at the Luxor up against the Two Queen Flamingo Room at the Flamingo. So without further ado, let's get started. Before we get started, if you're new to the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and join the TVP fam. And make sure to hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any content that's uploaded to the channel. Now, the Luxor and Flamingo are two very popular hotels amongst people who travel to Vegas simply because they're in the budget category and they're both on the Vegas Strip. So these two rooms that we're doing, they're both second tier-ish rooms, you could say, at each hotel. But they're also popular rooms that people like to book at these properties. So let's dive in and compare these rooms. Walking into the Luxor room, when you come in, you'll walk into your entryway. You can instantly tell that it does look like one of their updated rooms compared to the basic room. Got a nice simple entryway. Walking into the Flamingo room, the same thing. Once you come in, you also have like a narrow entryway, but compared to the base rooms, you'll definitely tell that the room has been more updated and remodeled. So just off of the initial entryway, both of the rooms, they don't make you say wow, but they definitely don't make you feel like you're walking into the cheapest hotel in Vegas. As I said, these are two second tier ish rooms, so it's a step up from their base rooms. But just off the initial factor, just because it seems like you can see more and it looks better off the initial eye test, I'll give the edge to the Luxor. So let's check out the bathrooms. Off to the right, when you walk into the Luxor room, you do have your bathroom. So when you come in, you have a nice clean bathroom. Got a big mirror above your single vanity sink. Nice, looks up to be updated countertop. You have your toilet, and then across you have your walk-in shower. So you've got some clean, simple, standard tiling with your shower head. So nice, cool walk-in shower. Then when you go over into the Flamingo room, when you walk in, this does look like it has been updated. You also have a single vanity sink. The countertop does look like it's been updated as well, with a bright mirror above the sink and a backlit or backlight behind it. You do have your toilet, and then across you also have your walk-in shower. Now, I've never been the biggest fan of these walk-in showers that actually don't have a door to close. But in this walk-in shower, you do have your dispensers. It does look like they've got some clean, modern, updated tiling as well. So just looking at both of these bathrooms, they both have the same things. Both have walk-in showers, both have a big mirror above the sink, and then the toilet in between. So as far as the bathrooms, the edge is gonna go to Flamingo just off of looks. Now, I know some people don't really like the dispensers, so I won't take away from them giving the dispensers as an option. Just off of the eye test though, I'll give the bathroom edge to the Flamingo. So let's check out the closet and bedroom space. So coming out of the bathroom in the Luxor room is your closet space. So it is a little narrow, but you do have an ironing board and some cubby slots. You also have an empty mini refrigerator in this space, so if you need to keep your drinks cool, that's convenient. There's also a in-room safe to lock up your valuables. Over in the bedroom space, you do have the two queen beds, and then above you do have a blue and white wallpaper. So that is a clean look, gives it a fresher look compared to the standard pyramid rooms. And then you have your nightstand in the middle with a light to control the reading lamps above. So that's convenient if people need that while they're in the bed. Coming into the Flamingo room, over to your right is your closet. So on one side of the sliding doors, you have your ironing board. Then the other side, you see some hangers. You do have got ice bucket and cups on top of some dresser drawers, so that's convenient if you want to store things. And then the bedroom space, you do have your two queen beds. There's also like a white and black wallpaper to give it a fresh, clean look over in the Flamingo room. So both these rooms have a clean, nice, simple look. When you look at the Flamingo room, you have an actual closet, but if you do need to store things, you do get a dresser drawer inside of the closet, and then you have your ironing board on a separate side. And then the Luxor room, it is a real narrow space, but I mean, you still have an ironing board. And for the mini refrigerator to be in the closet space, you know, it's an interesting location to have that, but at least you have one. And then in the bedroom space, both of them have the two queen beds. They both have wallpaper backgrounds to give it a fresher look. I'll just say simply because there's a closet in the Flamingo room, an actual closet, not like a little narrow space, I'll give the slight edge to the Flamingo. But aside from that, they're pretty much the same. so let's go check out the entertainment space. In the Luxor room across from your two queen beds is your entertainment space. So there's a flat screen TV above your dresser, and then you have plenty of drawers below if you need storage. That won't be an option here. Off to the side, you do have an additional chair for guests. And then there is a desk, so if you're in work in town and need a place to handle some business, you do have a nice size space to do so, where you'll also find your ice bucket and cups that are complimentary. Over in the flamingo room across from the beds, also you have a desk if you need to handle some work, that'll be there for you. And then you have a connectivity panel, so if you need to hook up some USB devices or standard outlet ports, you have that. Wall mounted flat screen TV above that. And then off to the side behind these two doors, you have your empty mini refrigerator, which is convenient if you need to keep your drinks cool. And then over to the side is your in-room safe to lock up your valuables. Then off to the side of these, you do have an extra chair, so if you have guests, they have a place to sit there and chill. So when it comes to the entertainment space, they both have tables, so if you need to do work while you're in town, you have a place to work. You do have a flat screen TV in the Luxor room, and I'm sure some of you are like, well, if there's an empty mini refrigerator in the Luxor room, the Flamingo better have one. They certainly do. It's just over more in the entertainment space instead of it being in their closet. But they both have most similar entertainment space things. I believe the TV might be slightly bigger in the Flamingo room, but the connectivity panel will be the slight edge for the entertainment space in the Flamingo room. So I'll give the slight edge to Flamingo. Now let's check out the views. In the Luxor room, your view was a cool view. It was more of a city slash partial strip view, I guess you could say. You could see most of the city from this slanted pyramid view, T-Mobile Arena, and some of the hotels, but I wouldn't consider it a major strip view. In the Flamingo room, you do have floor to ceiling windows, but this was also a city view, and it was also at night, so there wasn't really much to see, and it wasn't the greatest view, but it was a view. So with the Flamingo room, as you saw, there wasn't much of a view. Even during the day, you just pretty much saw the Flamingo towers, other side of the buildings, and then just views of the city. In the Luxor room, you did get to see some of the other hotel properties. You could also see some of the city as well. Neither were the greatest of views, but I would definitely take the Luxor view for sure. So I'll give the edge as far as views to the Luxor. But those are my breakdowns. Y'all know I always do the quick breakdowns of the two rooms, but this is a battle and a versus, and that is exactly why we have a scorecard. So let's pull out the scorecard and determine a winner for this battle. First on the scorecard, we have size. The premium queen room at Luxor was 420 square feet compared to the two queen flamingo room, which was 350 square feet. So on the scorecard for size, the edge is gonna go to Luxor. Next on the scorecard, we have location. Now both of these hotels are very popular hotels because, as I mentioned earlier, they are both on the Las Vegas Strip. However, when it comes to location, the Bellagio is at the center of the Strip. We use the Fountains of Bellagio to be our center point. The Luxor is the second to last hotel at the south end of the Strip. The Flamingo, however, is just a few hotels down from the Bellagio, so it is considered to be in the center area of the Strip. So when it comes to location, because the Flamingo is closer to the center of the Strip and is in the center area of the Strip, the edge for location is going to go to Flamingo. Third on the scorecard, we have price. Now for these versus battles, we pick three random months and three random weekends out of those months. We'll take the price, and then whichever room is cheaper will ultimately be the winner of the prices section. The first random weekend was in June. The Pyramid Premium Queen Room at Luxor was $409.13, which rounds to $137 a night. The two queen flamingo room at the Flamingo was $437.15, which rounds to $146 a night. So for the first random weekend, the edge would go to the Luxor room. The second random weekend was in August. The Pyramid Premium Queen Room at Luxor was $409.13, which rounds to $137 a night. At the Two Queen Flamingo Room, it was $457.30, which rounds to $153 a night. So for the second random weekend, the pricing edge would go to Luxor. The third random weekend was in November. The Pyramid Premium Queen Room at Luxor was $443.83, which rounds to $148 a night. The Two Queen Flamingo Room at the Flamingo was $539.69, which rounds to $180 a night. So for the third random weekend, and the overall edge for price would go to Luxor because it was cheaper all three weekends. Next on the scorecard, we have amenities. Now, both of these rooms basically have the same amenities. They both have an empty mini refrigerator, even though one might be in a weird location. They both have in-room safes. They both have flat screen TVs. There's a desk if you need to do work or if you just need a space to do anything with the desk. You get that in both rooms. However, for this particular battle, I'll give the edge to the Flamingo because you do have a connectivity panel that includes USB charging devices, and we all have USB devices nowadays. They also do have floor-to-ceiling windows, so even though the view wasn't the greatest from the Flamingo room, if you did have a good view, you would get a better view of it because of the floor-to-ceiling windows compared to the Lux room where you did have a nice view, but it's got that slanted window. And I know that's not really a popular thing for people who stay at the Luxor because you have floor-to-ceiling windows and the connectivity panel. I'll give that edge to Flamingo. Last on the scorecard, we have views. Now from this video, as you can see, both of these rooms were not strip view rooms. They were just basic rooms booked at that particular room. So the Flamingo Two Queen room was not a strip view. The Pyramid Premium Two Queen room, that was not a strip view. Those were just those base rooms. And the views were certainly better without a doubt. In the Luxor room, even if the Flamingo room was recorded during the day, the most you'd see is the city and the side of the Flamingo. So I'm almost certain most people would rather see other hotels and parts of the city instead of seeing the side of the hotel building. So for this battle, the view's edge is gonna go to the Luxor. So the winner of this versus is gonna be the Pyramid Premium Queen room at the Luxor, in my opinion, even though there's a scorecard, by a slight margin. Now, in all reality, when it comes to actually choosing these particular rooms in these particular hotels, I'm almost certain most people will prefer the Flamingo room because of the location of the Flamingo. The biggest knock that Luxor have is because it's the second to last hotel at the south end of the strip, so it's not in walking distance of anything. You have to hop in a tram just to go over to Excalibur in order to get in a walking distance, and then even from there you still gotta walk down to other places. So Flamingo of the two would be the more popular hotel because of its location, and location is very important to a lot of people. But this is a versus, so Luxor got the edge in this versus. Drop your comments below and let me know what you all would like to see in future episodes of versus. Let me know what y'all thought about this versus. Would you have taken the Luxor Pyramid Premium room? Would you have taken the Flamingo Two Queen Flamingo room? I appreciate all the feedback with these verses, and that's gonna do it for this video. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe if you're new, and as always, thanks for watching.